Hello learners, in this session we will learn trial balance and in that we can learn meaning of trial balance, objectives and preparation of trial balance as per the format. In that we have to study a term called suspense account and what is the need for a suspense account in case the trial balance does not tally. Till this session we have studied journal, ledger and different special purpose book. Why we are making the balance of different ledger accounts? Because next procedure is there and that procedure is preparation of the trial balance. Trial balance may be defined as a statement which contains balances of all ledger accounts on a particular date. At the end of the accounting year, different accounts are balanced. We have already studied different accounts are balanced at the end of accounting year. And to check the accuracy of posting in the ledger, a statement is prepared and that statement is known as trial balance. And this statement contains debit column and credit column. In the debit column, we will write the debit balances of account. In the credit column, we will write credit balances of accounts. If the total of the two columns are equal, it means the ledger posting is arithmetically correct. Here, debit column total is 80,000. Assume that. Then credit column total should also be 80,000. Then it is arithmetically correct. And the statement which shows this is called the trial balance. In the trial balance, we have a debit column with all debit balances of account and a credit column with all credit balances of account. The totals of these columns, if tally, it is presumed that ledger has been maintained correctly. You can only assume that it is correctly maintained. Trial balance proves the arithmetical accuracy of posting in the ledger. Why we are preparing trial balance? So, objective of preparing trial balance includes the following, like to check the arithmetical accuracy, to help in preparing financial statements. Trial balance helps in locating errors. It also helps in comparison. It helps in making adjustments also. So, as an objective to check arithmetical accuracy, we should study that in detail. Arithmetical accuracy in ledger posting means writing correct amount in the correct account and on the correct side when we are posting transactions from various original books of accounts like cash book, purchases book, sales book, etc. It also means not only the correct balance of ledger account but also the total of special purpose books. So, correct amount should be written in the correct account and in the correct account in the correct side you have to write all the amounts. Then you have to check that the total of special purpose book also should be correct. Then only trial balance will help to check the arithmetical accuracy. As another objective, trial balance helps in preparing financial statements. Why we are doing the accounting process? The ultimate objective of accounting is to prepare financial statements. That is, if you are studying, you want to know the result at last, how much percentage you are getting, whether you are passing, like that. Why the organization is preparing various journals, ledger and trial balance financial statements. Why it is prepared to know the profit or loss, whether the business is making or not. So, the objective of accounting is to prepare financial statements. Which are the financial statements? Trading account, profit and loss account and balance sheet. These are prepared by taking the balance from the trial balance. And usually financial statements are prepared at the end of accounting year. These statements contain, that is, trading account, profit and loss account, and balance sheet contain balances of various ledger accounts. And trial balance contains balances of all the ledger accounts. And in financial statement, the balances of the ledger accounts are carried from the trial balance for proper analysis. So, balances of ledger accounts are taken from the trial balance and it is written in the financial statements for what? For analysis. Whether the organization is making profit, how much assets and liabilities are there. In order to ascertain these things, we are preparing financial statements. Trial balance helps in locating errors. If the total of two columns of the trial balance agrees, it is a proof of arithmetical accuracy in the ledger posting. See, here two columns are equal. 66,000 in the debit column and 66,000 in the credit column. So, the totals of the debit and credit are same. This can be ascertained from the trial balance. Another objective of preparing trial balance, it helps in locating errors. If the total of the two columns do not tally, it indicates that there are some mistake in the ledger accounts. This helps the accountant to find out the errors. See, here in this trial balance, total of the debit amount column is 66,000 and total of the credit amount column is 96,000. So, arithmetically, if you are checking, the trial balance is not tallying. So, there is some mistake that we have made in preparing the accounts. We have to do the balancing and find out where such errors have occurred. So, accountant will be doing this work when he is seeing that there is difference in the trial balance total. Another objective of preparing trial balance, it helps in comparison. Comparison of ledger account balances of 1 year with the corresponding balances with the previous year helps the management taking some important decisions. This is possible by using the trial balance of the 2 years. See, cash in hand of 2011 and 2012, 4,000, 8,000. Cash at bank of 2011 and 2012. Like that, trial balance helps us to make comparison also. Objective of preparing trial balance, it helps in making adjustments. While making financial statements, adjustments regarding closing stock, prepaid expenses, outstanding expenses are to be made. Trial balance helps in identifying the items requiring adjustments in preparing the financial statements. Preparation of trial balance. Usually, trial balance is prepared at the end of accounting year. However, it can be prepared at any time during the accounting year to check the accuracy of the posting. At this point, you should know that trial balance is not an account. It is only a list of balances of ledger accounts, including cash balance and bank balance. And it is prepared on a particular date. The accounts having a debit balance are entered in the debit amount column and credit balance accounts are entered in the credit amount column. The total of the two sides of the account may be used to prepare the trial balance. The sum of each column should be equal. See, debit column and credit column here in this slide are equal with 55,000 as amount. Here is the format of preparing the trial balance. Trial balance of dash organization as at a particular date, usually the closing date. It is having four columns with name of the account, first column, second column with ledger folio, and third column with debit amount balance, fourth column with credit amount balance. The name of the business firm is written on the top of the statement of trial balance. Under this, we write the date on which trial balance is prepared. Here I have given an example, trial balance of Saxena Limited, name of the organization, as at a particular date, that is the closing date usually. Trial balance has four columns, name of the ledger account, ledger folio, debit amount and credit amount. In the first column, we write the name of the account. In the debit amount column, we write the name of the debit balance of the account. In the credit amount column, we write the amount of the credit balance of the account. In the ledger folio column, we write the folio number of the ledger accounts. Columnar total is done while preparing the trial balance, that is after writing the name of the account and writing all the amounts in the debit column and in the credit column. You have to total both columns, that is the debit amount column and credit amount column, and then you have to compare it. Once again, I am summing up the steps to prepare trial balance. At first, ascertain the balance account wise of all the ledger accounts. Write the name of the ledger account in the ledger account column. Write against the name of the ledger account the balance amount, debit balance in the debit column and credit balance in the credit column. Capital is having credit balance, so I have written in the credit balance amount column. Sales usually credit balance, so in the credit amount column. Purchases debit balance, stock is an asset, so debit balance in the debit amount column. Add the debit balance column and credit balance column. See, here in this slide, we have added the debit balance and it came to 2,11,500, and credit balance also should come to 2,11,500. Here, this answer is correct because two sides are tallying. Trial balance and errors. If the totals do not tally, it means there are some errors in recording or in posting in the ledger of business transactions. There can be many reasons with which the totals of the two columns of the trial balance may not agree. Why the totals of the trial balance are not agree? It can be because of the following reasons, like the total of the special purpose books are not done correctly, or there is some mistake in the posting of these totals. Another mistake can be like this. The items from special purpose books may be posted on the wrong side of the account. Sometimes items from the journal may be posted on the wrong side of the account. And in other cases, wrong amount may be posted in wrong account. Other errors can be while balancing the account. Balancing may not be done correctly. Total while calculating the balance may not be done correctly. There may be mistake in carrying balance from the ledger account to the trial balance also. 1500 will be written as 150. 2500 will be written as 250. Like that, so many mistakes may also occur while transferring the balance from the ledger account to the trial balance. So, when I am concluding this, if the trial balance is in agreement, the business transactions have been correctly recorded, or transactions have been posted correctly into the ledger. However, the agreement of trial balance is not a proof of the correctness of recording transactions. Agreement of trial balance is not a proof of correctness of posting business transactions also. There can be errors, and the sum of each column of the trial balance may still be equal. As you have learned that business transactions are so recorded that all debits have the credits for the same amount and all credits have the debits for the same amount. So the trial balance must necessarily agree. But if the debits are matched by credits, though there are mistakes in recording and posting, the trial balance will still agree. For example, if goods have been purchased from Surinder and if not entered in the purchases book, this error will not affect the agreement of the trial balance because you have not entered in the purchases book. From there, you have not done any posting, so you will not identify this error. Now, suppose the trial balance does not agree. That is, there is a difference of some amount in the totals of the two columns of the trial balance. What will you do with this difference? The difference amount is put in the suspense account. You will open a new account known as suspense account, and the difference in totaling which you have identified while preparing the trial balance is put in the suspense account. And after putting the amount in the suspense account, this will result in agreement of the trial balance. In which column you will write the amount when you are putting the suspense account? Suspense account will be put on the shorter side of the trial balance with the difference amount you have identified while totaling the trial balance. Here is an example. Total of the debit column, here I have given 4 items: capital 1 lakh, sales 70,000, purchases 80,000, and stock 1 lakh. Debit column is having a total of 1,80,000 and credit column is having a total of 1,70,000. Total of the debit column exceeds the total of the credit column by ₹10,000. This amount of ₹10,000 will be written on the credit column against suspense account to make the trial balance agree. So, suspense account is a temporary arrangement to make the trial balance agree. Suspense account will show balance till the errors are rectified. Suspense account will disappear as soon as all the errors are rectified. Here is one more representation of the trial balance where there is a difference in the two columns, debit column and credit column. Debit balance is having a shortage of ₹6,800. And we have transferred this amount to the suspense account. In this example, we see that the totals of the two columns of the trial balance do not tally. Credit side is more than that of the debit side by ₹6,800. It is to make the two columns of the trial balance equal. Suspense account is written in the column against it is written the amount of ₹6,800 in the debit column. And as soon as the errors are rectified, this suspense account will not be seen in the trial balance. That is, suspense account will show no balance and it will disappear from the trial balance. Here is a question to prepare the trial balance. From the following balances extracted from the books of a trader, prepare trial balance as on 31st March 2014. Cash in hand 4,200, cash at bank 16,800, bills receivable 18,000, bills payable 16,000, debtors 24,600, creditors 32,400, capital 50,000. Drawings 18,000, sales 1,05,000, purchases 75,000, carriage inward 2,700, salaries 12,000, advertisement 2,400, insurance 1,600, furniture 7,500, stock 18,600 and office rent 2,000. You have to write the heading trial balance as on, trial balance of a particular organization if the organization name is given, as on a particular date if the date is given. Then name of the account in the first column, ledger folio, second column, debit balance in the third column and credit balance in the fourth column. Cash in hand is an asset, so will be shown in the debit amount column. Cash at bank, asset. Assets will have debit balance, so it should come in the debit amount column. Bills receivable, asset. Asset will have debit balance, so shown in the debit amount column. Bills payable, liability. It will have credit balance so shown in the credit amount column. Debtors asset so shown in the debit amount column. Creditors liability so shown in the credit amount column. Capital is a liability, so it should be written in the credit amount column. Continuation of that trial balance. Drawings in the debit amount column. It is a deduction from the capital, so it is written in the debit amount column. Sales, revenue or income. Incomes will have credit balance, so written in the credit amount column. Purchases, expenses in the debit amount column. Carriage inward, expense, debit amount column. Salaries, expense, debit amount column. Advertisement, expense, debit amount column. Insurance, expense, debit amount column. Furniture, asset, debit amount column. Stock is an asset, so in the debit amount column. Rent is an expense in the debit amount column. If otherwise, rent received, they will mention, then it will come in the credit amount column. So, here we have written correctly all the amounts in the respective columns. So, we got the total equal, that is 2,03,400. Here there is another question. State whether the following accounts be put on the debit side or credit side of a trial balance. Capital, purchases, interest received, sales, furniture, purchase returns, salary, plant, sales returns, drawings, bad debt, discount allowed, bank account, discount received. See, in the trial balance, where these items are coming, we have to locate capital. It is a liability, so on the credit amount column. Plant, it is an asset, so in the debit amount column. Purchases, expense, in the debit amount column. Sales returns, deducted from the sales, so in the debit amount column. At this point, I would like to say, sales is an income, so sales returns will have a debit balance. Purchases is an expense, so will have debit balance. Purchase returns will have a credit balance. It's opposite. Purchases, debit. Purchase returns, credit. Sales, credit. Sales returns, debit. Then, interest received, income. So, credit balance. Drawings deducted from the capital, debit balance. Sales, income, credit balance. Bad debt, loss, debit balance. Furniture, asset. So, written in the debit amount column. Discount allowed, loss, written in the debit amount column. Purchase returns, deducted from purchases, so in the credit amount column. Bank account, asset, in the debit amount column. Salary is an expense, so in the debit amount column. Discount received is an income, so it will be written in the credit amount column. One more question. Prepare a trial balance of Amal as on 31st March 2015. He has omitted to open capital account. Bank overdraft, sales, purchases, debtors, wages, opening stock, creditors, purchase returns, cash in hand, sales returns and furniture are given. We have to identify the capital and we have to prepare trial balance. Trial balance as on that date that is given in the question, then bank overdraft liability, so in the credit amount column, sales income, credit amount column, purchase returns, credit amount column, purchases, debit amount column, purchases, expense in the debit amount column, cash in hand, asset in the debit amount column, debtors, asset in the debit amount column, sales in the credit amount column and sales returns in the debit amount column. Wages, expense, debit amount column. Furniture, asset, debit amount column. Opening stock, asset, debit amount column. Creditors, liability, credit amount column. You have to total both columns. And we have identified a difference of 117,500 in the credit amount, which you can transfer to the capital account. So, you have to write in the name of the account, capital, and the amount, which is a difference of 117,500 in the credit amount column. The totals of the debit amount and credit amount came to 834,500, which shows that this account is perfectly correct, or till the preparation of the trial balance, all the accounts are maintained very correctly. Dear learners, in this session, we have studied the meaning of trial balance, objectives of preparing the trial balance, and we have studied the preparation of the trial balance as per the format. We have also identified the need for a suspense account in case the trial balance does not tally. Dear learners, hope you understood this session very well. Thank you.
घर बैठे पाएं राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालय शिक्षा संस्थान यानी NIOS में एडमिशन, वो भी एकदम आसान तरीके से, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को होगी समय और धन दोनों की बचत। NIOS से शिक्षा कभी भी कहीं भी। शिक्षार्थियों, क्या आप जानते हैं NIOS में एडमिशन लेने का सरल और सुगम तरीका, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को ऑनलाइन प्रवेश लेने में सहूलियत मिलती है। NIOS में प्रवेश की प्रक्रिया पूर्णतया ऑनलाइन है। शिक्षार्थी घर बैठे इंटरनेट द्वारा प्रवेश के लिए सबसे पहले NIOS की वेबसाइट www.nios.ac.in पर लॉगिन करें। अपना ईमेल आईडी और पासवर्ड डालकर अपना पंजीकरण करें। पंजीकरण के बाद लॉगिन करने पर ऑनलाइन प्रवेश हेतु आवेदन पत्र खुलेगा। आवेदन पत्र को निर्देशानुसार भरें और प्रिंट आउट लें। इस प्रिंट आउट पर अपनी फोटो संलग्न करें। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश के लिए शुल्क हेतु भुगतान के तरीके हैं: क्रेडिट कार्ड के द्वारा, डेबिट कार्ड के द्वारा, राष्ट्रीयकृत बैंक के ड्राफ्ट के माध्यम से, जो कि सचिव NIOS नई दिल्ली या नोएडा के पक्ष में देय हो। भरे हुए आवेदन पत्र के साथ साथ डिमांड ड्राफ्ट और संलग्न किए जाने वाले दस्तावेज हैं जन्म रजिस्ट्रार के जिला कार्यालय से जारी जन्म प्रमाण पत्र की सत्यापित प्रति, जिसमें जन्म तिथि अंकित हो, पिछले विद्यालय से प्राप्त विद्यालय छोड़ने का प्रमाण पत्र जिसमें आवेदक की जन्म तिथि लिखी हो, प्रवेश फॉर्म का प्रिंट आउट NIOS के संबद्ध क्षेत्र केंद्रों पर 10 दिनों में पहुंच जाना चाहिए, अन्यथा उचित दस्तावेज ना लगे होने पर आवेदन फॉर्म रद्द किया जा सकता है। प्रवेश प्रक्रिया की पुष्टि होने के बाद शिक्षार्थियों को परिचय पत्र व अध्ययन सामग्री डाक द्वारा तुरंत पहुंचाई जाती है। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश एक बहुत ही सुगम और सुविधाजनक प्रवेश प्रणाली है। ऑनलाइन ऑन टाइम फॉर सेफ एंड सिक्योर एडमिशन।